Well, I think people in Damascus were just as astonished as people in the United States, in the Arab world, frankly, all over the planet at that decision. I think the first reaction came just a couple of minutes after President Obama finished speaking, when Syria's army began shelling rebel-held suburbs here in Damascus after a day of quiet. And then came the mocking. In newspaper headlines, for example, one read, "The American retreat starts here." Syria's deputy prime minister said Obama's delay was laughable. And today I spoke to Syria's deputy foreign minister, Faisal Mekdad, who said he wasn't surprised by Obama's decision because Obama and the administration are lost. They don't know where they're going. And he said he hoped that the wise people in the US Congress would do what MPs in the British House of Commons did and vote against military action. But he said if that happened, if there was action, Syria's army is absolutely ready. Of course, there is another side to Syria. It's a deeply divided country. And for the rebels and the opposition here, President Obama's decision is something of a betrayal.
So just to be clear about this, the president doesn't look careful. He doesn't look constitutionally minded. He looks to the eyes of Syrians on both sides weak.
I think President Assad will finish this week thinking he has weakened his enemies. He's had, by his standards, a very good week, with the British saying no to military action and the Americans delaying it. And actually, just in the last few minutes, there's been a pretty heavy bombardment by the army of rebel-held suburbs. So President Assad, we've said this so often, he is defiant and undeterred. Perhaps this week he has more reason than most to be those things.